My name is Dai Yoshihara. I'm a driver for Falken tire, discount tire, Subaru BRZ. And we're here at the Homestead Raceway in Miami. This is Formula Drift Round 3 in 2014. And this is actually our first time coming into Miami as Formula Drift Series. And I'm really excited about it. You know, I started drifting like 15 years ago. My first car was like $300. But I think the fact on the street, I mean, I shouldn't say street, but just for fun kind of car to drift, it hasn't been changed. You know, it's still just like a basic. You just need a rear-wheel drive car and maybe, you know, lock the diff. That's about it. But the professional drift car these days is getting a lot more serious, more expensive, and it's basically the race car, you know. So, but when the Formula Drift started in 2004, it was more like a street car plus, but now it's complete race car. Pretty much we can drift with any kind of car, but it's always easier to start with the right prep foam. I mean, this is a Subaru BRZ, but you know, we modify so much, so it's not even, we don't really have much OEM parts on it, but still the frame is the OEM, and then we can move the suspension pickup points so much. So yeah, it's always better to start with a good platform. I've been driven a lot of different cars in my career. I drove a S13 240SX from Nissan, and I had a GTO from Pontiac. It was a big car with a big V8, and also a Lexus IS350. And this is actually the other car, Subaru BRZ. And you know, each car has a different character, and it's all different. But I'm so used to the way with the Nissan 240s, which is more like a basic drift car in the world, like the best basic car, I guess. So this one is a little bit harder to get the setup right. Last two rounds, we actually didn't do well, but we just finished the practice session in round 3, and I think we're getting better. So we're still tweaking the setup here and there, but so far I think we're in a good position right now. So this BRZ, we got the Chevy LS-based V8 motor with the big single turbo. So with the tune we've done, we are making around 1,000 horsepower right now. But we can make it even more if we wanted to. But so far, I think it's enough horsepower with the setup we have right now. It depends what the level of drifting you're talking about, but definitely drifting is getting more expensive. But I mean, I'm talking about the Formula Drift. It's just because we're the one of the best drift series in the world. So we are pretty much leading the scene. That's why you have to have like really nice cars, competitive cars, and you know, it just ended up kind of pricey. I mean, there's still the way to make it cheap, but all the top cars are getting pretty expensive. Personally, I don't like it's getting too expensive because it's hard for, you know, the beginner drivers to, you know, follow up. And like these days, it's getting like a horsepower battle. I mean, I have one of the highest horsepower car in the series too, but till last year we didn't have that power. And if someone has it in the top, you know, top driver, then we have to come up with it too, you know. I just don't like this nature, like being like horsepower battle, but it just, we have to do it. Unless they're gonna make the rule to restrict the power or something. Anyways, Yeah, pro drift is getting expensive, but the amateur drift or just to experience drifting isn't expensive at all. It's same as 20 years ago. You just need a rear wheel drive car and maybe LSD differential or just lock the deck and then you can just drift. And these days, it's not that much nice brand new car come out from the manufacturer, but Subaru BRZ or Scion, you can just drift, off the shelf. So it's the way of having fun driving. So hopefully, I think those manufacturer likes the fact that we are using their platform for drifting, and you don't have to compete. You just have fun. Drifting is really fun. Good.
I think you're about to get
photobombed. Oh shit. You good?